kettlebell psoas release. Now we're getting into that psoas muscle, that hip flexor muscle, one of the most important muscles in the body. The only one that attaches upper body to lower body. Big cause of lower back pain, big cause of tension, all the above. So with your kettlebell handle, we are gonna lean on top of it. Now be careful where you go with this. We're gonna make sure we get the right spot. So you've got your hip bone, we're going just inside that and down and up from there. So trying to get the length of that kettlebell just inside that hip bone. Take your time, gradually lowering yourself onto it, and you'll know when you find it because it just doesn't get very nice. From there, again, we're just gonna breathe. You don't really need to do anything here. Just let gravity do its thing. But what you can do as well is use your breath. So a nice deep breath in as your abdomen pushes out, hold, contract it, let it all go. Do that several times and you'll find yourself getting deeper and deeper onto that kettlebell. Now, if this isn't quite working for you, you do have the other option of popping the kettlebell on top of you. Careful you don't drop it on yourself. But this time you're gonna place that handle in that exact same spot. Again, careful of the bone, careful of the gut. You should know exactly where to get it because you'll feel it quite nicely. So using your hands, push down slightly. If you want some added reassurance, know you're in the right spot, just lift up your knee and you should feel that muscle kind of work. That's that hip flexion. So again, nice deep breath. Hold and contract. And let it go. Let it sink into that psoas position. Take your time with this, several breaths, and enjoy that release of that psoas muscle.